Hello everyone, welcome to the Backbenchers. Please do subscribe and hit the bell icon if you haven't done yet. Okay, let's start. Let's move forward. We were doing the syllabus thing and we were doing separately the analysis of every units, and in which we were covering the introductory macroeconomics. And today we are going to cover the second unit. First we have done. So the money and banking unit contains 6 marks of your question paper, where they can ask you. There are high chances of asking very short and short answers from this chapter. So please be prepared. Whenever you are going to do this chapter, you have to have in your mind that, okay, very short and short sort of answers will be asked or probably can be asked, right? So basically, let's quickly see about the money. Okay, so money and, you know, you need to know the concept of the money. See, aisa sabko pata hai ki what is paisa kya hai, you know, it is financially upliftment, ye wo. Aisa nahi, aapko uska concept pata hona chahiye, proper concept. Okay, then you need to know about the supply of money. How does this happen? What is the procedure? Okay, it is quite long. So, uska procedure kya hai? Then you need to know jo bhi currency hai held by public and net demand deposits held by the commercial banks. Okay, how commercial banks help? What is the system behind the currency? What is the system? What is the procedure? What is their propaganda? And so on. Now, just imagine if the second unit would be a person, how would, you know, that they would react? Can you imagine something? Just imagine, what am I gonna show you? Just imagine this thing. It is something quite funny. So if unit second would be a person, they would be like this, no? It's quite funny. Yeah, all around money and money, right? Chalo, let's move forward. So basically, the remaining things which consist in the money section is the money creation by the commercial banking system. How do they create money? Okay, abhi, you should know the tricks. You should know the system and their policies, their procedures, their steps which should be taken accordingly. You should know all these things. So that is what we are going to cover. And then you should know about the central bank and its functions. Central bank is RBI. I hope everybody knows. So how do they issue, government bank? Bankers bank kaise hai, government kaise help karti hai, aur RBI jo hai, how do they issue the currency, the money, and so on. So that you need to cover, that you need to see and manage separately. Okay, so this is what you need to do. Okay, that's what it is. So basically this was it. Now I am not able to say bye in the graphic sense. So bye-bye. I'll see you soon. This was it. You need to cover 6 marks from this chapter. Okay, this chapter is very important because very short answers can be asked and even short answers. And you should, abhi aisa hota hai ki agar 2 mark ka question hai, agar aapne ekdam sahi likh diya hai, toh you will get 2 marks. Okay, nobody can cut your marks even in theory. So please be very conceptual. Okay, so you should keep on remaining that unit first, jo ki national income tha, that was containing 10 marks, and unit second is containing 6 marks. So by completing this, you will cover 16 marks out of 80. Okay, so that's how you need to go. That is what I have said in the last class, in the last video, and this is what I'm saying right now. So please be very prepared. Do not just don't be just very casual. Okay, I'll see you in while explaining the third unit. Till then, bye bye, tata, jai mata di.